Now, just to give you a little preview of what happens in Lesson 10.2, I do have a few contemporary sounds in Indonesian music right here. And so we will listen to those, again, some excerpts, and you'll start to get a sense of how these traditional values have come into the contemporary music. Now, I should give you a heads up on this first video here. You're going to see a genre called dangdut. That's a particular genre of Indonesian popular music. It might be like, you know, if you think about American popular music, and there's a difference between grunge and rock and emo and things like that. So there's some different kinds of popular genres in Indonesia. And dangdut is a more long established, and some people might look at like you know, classic rock stations in the United States doing things from the 70s and 80s, and some bands being kind of just updating some of the classic rock type of music. And dangdut is that older kind of music, and people still enjoy it today, but it might be kind of seen as a retro kind of thing. And this particular TV program from Indonesian national TV could be seen as, I don't know, Indonesian Idol. I mean, there is an actual Indonesian Idol, which you will see. But this is that kind of presentation. And the other thing I want you to zero in on is, excuse me, that in the short interludes between the vocal verses, you see this singer doing traditional Indonesian dancing. And I think that's a really interesting connection of the old and the new. Okay, the next excerpt might be thought of as Indonesian MTV, a music video, mixing a lot of interesting things here. I should have mentioned in that first video that in the Dangdut, you still had real strong connections to the tradition Indonesian vocal aesthetic. It doesn't sound like an Indonesian female singer trying to sound like an American R&B singer. And you do have that sometimes. I think our Korean students and Japanese students are familiar with artists in their countries who are really trying to do a vocal aesthetic that's closer to Beyonce and closer to Rihanna than to traditional Japanese or Korean singing. The male singer Rain comes to mind in Korea as someone who's doing a pop style that's more like American boy band style than traditional Korean vocal aesthetic. Well, here we have an artist who's really not trying to do that, trying to keep more of an Indonesian vocal aesthetic. And this second video is the same kind of thing. It takes a while for you to get into the actual Indonesian lyric of the song. You have some vocalizations and kind of interplay with the flute that's almost jazzy in its presentation, but you'll see some interesting images in the video, references and visions and images of traditional dress and culture and dancing, and then you'll kind of get a feeling it's one of those contemporary world music or what we call world beat songs that's brings in elements of African American dance music.
Thank you.
Yeah, the next video features the band Krakatau, a very popular band in Indonesia, been around for a long time. And you have to get past this really random and frankly pretty cheesy music video concept with sci-fi and aliens and that kind of thing. But some good funky music here. Krakatau is known as a jazz fusion band. Mixing elements of jazz and R&B and funk music. So, and you hear an Indonesian rap, no other way to describe it. So take a look, you can have a chuckle at some of the video production values, but pay attention to the music and kind of sort out in your minds what's traditional in terms of the instrumentation and the rhythm patterns and things like that, and what's contemporary. And by the way, when you see this long-haired guy playing the fretless bass, he is an amazing bass player. I'd love to hear him and Flea from Red Hot Chili Peppers face off in a bass battle. That would be really cool. Check it out. All right, the next video I'm going to call Six Dazzling Dangdut Divas and Some Random Guy. When you watch the video, you'll see what I mean. But again, listen to what's contemporary, what's traditional. Hopefully you're going to zero in on the fact that you're hearing the idiophones, the bell-like idiophones in this hook of this popular song. And you're going to hear a very traditional female vocal aesthetic. But beyond that, what else is traditional? What else, and by contrast, what's contemporary in this?
Oh,
Okay, now to introduce the next video, all of you know about AI, right? American Idol. Well, did you know about II, Indonesian Idol? Take a look at the video. You're going to see the same type of logo. You know, Simon Cowell and his partner, what is his name? Simon Fuller, whatever his the other Simon is, have branded this and taken it international. So 200 million people, big market, love music, popular music from the West, very popular there. So you basically have an R&B slow jam here with Baja Indonesia lyrics. And listen to the vocal aesthetic, because now you're going to start to get away from the traditional. So if you compare the last video with those six divas, very traditional vocal aesthetic, and then listen to this young lady sounding a lot more like Kelly Clarkson to me, you know, or a typical American rock diva in a mellow, slow jam kind of setting. So listen for this and see the contrast. There's nothing about this that comes through as traditionally Indonesian at all. And there you have it. That's the sneak preview for what we'll be covering in Lesson 10.2 as we bring traditional Indonesian elements into the current 20th and 21st century mix, the way we have with many other cultures. So until then, aloha.